Hello students, this is the second lecture of the circle. In previous lecture, we discussed about center radius form and diameter form, which can be used to find the equation of circle. Now, in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the general equation of circle. Consider the center radius form, which is x minus h the whole square plus y minus k the whole square is equal to r square. Now, after solving these brackets on left hand side, it can be written as x square minus 2hx plus h square plus y square minus 2ky plus k square minus r square is equal to 0. Now, shuffling these terms a bit, we can write this as x square plus y square minus 2hx minus 2ky plus h square plus k square minus r square is equal to 0. Now, for simplification purpose, we are following some substitution. Let h be minus g and k be minus f. Further, h square plus k square minus r square are replaced by c. Now, this substitution gives me x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Now, this is the general equation of the circle. Now, if circle's equation is given in this form, how can I find its center or how can I find its radius? Try to understand that this equation is obtained from the center radius form in which the center is h, k. By the way, h and k we replaced by minus g and minus f. So, center here is minus g minus f. This is the center for the general equation of the circle. Now, to find radius, I am using the substitution h square plus k square minus r square is equal to c. Now, modifying this equation, we can write h square plus k square minus c is r square. Further, h and k, as we replace them by minus g and minus f, so this becomes g square plus f square minus c is equal to r square. So, radius can be written as root of g square plus f square minus c. This is the formula for radius of the circle. Now, what we discussed, the general form of the circle is x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is 0. Now, what is the purpose or what is the use of general form of the circle? Just try to understand that every equation of circle can be expressed in the general form of the circle. Or you can compare the given equation of circle with general form of the circle. And then center of the circle can be written as minus g minus f. And radius of the circle can be obtained by the formula root of g square plus f square minus c. Now, I'm moving for next point. Consider the equation ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. This equation is called a second degree non-homogeneous equation in x and y. This is second degree non-homogeneous equation. In x and y. Now we are trying to understand when such equation represents circle. So conditions for such equation representing circle. The first condition is coefficient of x square must be equal to coefficient of y square. Now coefficient of x square is a, coefficient of y square is b. So a must be equal to b. So, this is the first condition. The second condition is coefficient of xy should be 0. The coefficient of xy is 2h. So, one can write h is 0 or 2h is 0. Means h is 0. So, this is the second condition. And the third condition what we are following is radius must be valid. Now, radius must be valid means, so try to understand, radius is given by formula root of g square plus f square minus c. This is the formula for the radius. So radius must be real value, but non-zero. Now, why I'm talking about non-zero? Because if radius is zero, it will not represent circle. It will represent a point that may be called as point circle. Now, I'm giving you one example for understanding this. See, consider one circle whose equation is x square plus y square minus 2x plus 4y plus 5 is equal to 0. Now, if you understand, the coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square both are same. XY coefficient is 0. So, first two conditions are satisfied here. But now, if I start getting radius, like 2g value is minus 2. So, g value is minus 1. 2f value is 4. F can be written as 2. And the constant c is 5. Now, what is radius formula according to our theory? It is root of g square plus f square minus c. So, if you calculate root of g square plus f square minus c, it will be 1 plus 4 minus 5. So, radius is 0. Now, in this case, it will not represent a circle. It will represent a point. And then this is considered as a point circle. It is representing a point. That's why this is called as point circle. So one can remember, if radius is zero, the equation represents point circle. So what is the condition for point circle? Radius must be zero. So in such cases, it is not a circle, it is a point. So that's why the third condition, whatever I have mentioned, is radius must be valid. Now, based on this general equation or whatever the conditions, we solve few questions. So here is the first question. If y is equal to 2x plus k is diameter of the circle, then k equals 2. Now, here I start with the solution. See, the equation of circle given is 2x square plus 2y square plus 3x plus 4y minus 1 is 0. Now, first of all, I'm dividing this equation by 2 throughout. So, it becomes x square plus y square. Now, when you divide here by 2, it becomes 3 by 2x. Then divided by 2, it becomes 2y and minus half is 0. Now, this equation can be compared with the general form. Somebody may bother, why you have divided by 2? So, reason is, I can compare it with the general form now. And after comparing it with the general form, one can write the value of g and f. So, the value of 2g is 3 upon 2. And then, here if you want, I can mention the value of 2g is 3 upon 2. And the value of 2f is 2. From this, I can write the value of g is 3 upon 4 and the value of f is 1. Now, what next is? From this, we can say that center of the circle is minus 3 by 4 comma minus 1. Because that was the theory what we discussed. Center of the circle is minus g comma minus f. Now, what is the use of center? Just look at the question carefully. They are saying that circle is having diameter y is equal to 2x plus k. Now, as 2x plus k is diameter, it must pass through the center. So, center's coordinates, if I put in the diameter's equation, it must satisfy. So, now I'm putting the center coordinates. Left hand side y is replaced by minus 1 and then this x is replaced by minus 3 by 4. Further, this can be written as 2 and this 2 2s are 4. So this can be written as k is equal to, now this minus 3 by 2 goes to other side. So it becomes 3 by 2 minus 1. It's done then. Problem is solved. We got the value of k, that is 1 by 2. So this is very simple if you understand how to get the center of the circle from the general equation of the circle. Now, for general equation, what I have done first is we have divided the equation by 2. Then we can compare it with the general equation of the circle. Got values of g and f. From that we obtained center. As diameter was given, we applied theory. The diameter passes through the center. As diameter is passing through the center, center's coordinates we substituted and got the value of k. So as such, it was very simple to apply. I hope all of you understood this. Moving for the next question now. The question is, the value of k if the equation represents a point circle. Now it is very important to note that the circle mentioned is point circle. So point circle was actually the circle with the radius 0. Now how we can solve this then? Again, they have given the circle's equation. Here also there is 2x square plus 2y square. So I'm dividing by 2. So equation becomes x square plus y square minus 3x plus 4y plus k by 2 is 0. Now again, this equation can be compared with x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is 0. So we can write the value of g is minus 3 by 2. Value of f is 2 and c is k by 2. Now, as circle is point circle, one can write the radius is 0. Correct? Now, radius is 0. The formula for the radius, what we studied, was root of g square plus f square minus c. And that I have equated with 0. In next step, if you want, I mention here, we are squaring both sides. So, we got it as g square plus f square minus c is 0. Now substituting the values of g, f and c, whatever we obtained here, one can write here is 9 by 4, that is minus 3 by 2 square. Then 2 square is 4 and c value is k by 2. So those values I just substituted here. And now we are going to simplify this. For simplification, I'm multiplying throughout by 4. So it becomes 9 plus 16 minus 2k. Just try to understand, multiply by 4. So it becomes 9 plus 16 minus 2k. Further, this can be written as minus 2k is minus 25. And then in next step, k value can be written as 25 by 2. So our answer is option C, that is 25 by 2. Now check. This is again very simple question. It was based on point circle and the general equation of circle. You can easily compare the general equation of the circle with x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is 0. From general equation, one can obtain the radius or center with the help of values g, f and c. Since it was point circle mentioned here, we obtained the radius which we equated with 0. And we got the required value of k. So here we stop with the lecture. Thank you.